move to Nidhi Bhoyer. She will be presenting her presentation. Over to you, Nidhi.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning to all present here. I am Nidhi Bhoyer, studying in class 12 from Model School, Nagpur, India. Is going to present and share my knowledge about the impact of COVID-19 pandemic on the economy of South Asian countries, which will include India, Nepal, Bangladesh, and Uganda. COVID-19's outbreak had a widespread impact on the health conditions along with the economic conditions of the countries. The South Asian countries were among the immensely clashed countries. Over 50 million people lost their lives. The death toll reached 1.2 million by the end of November 2020 and then continued to rise. It resulted in sharp changes on major economic indicators and sectors. Bangladesh had 40% decline in its economy and 0.89 million jobs at risk. Speaking about Nepal, almost every sector was slashed, showing up to 0.13% of GDP. Now we shall proceed towards the impact of COVID-19 on major economic indicators. Existence of COVID in the economy failed the upcoming government and organizational plans and also the present market, which henceforth affected the growth of major indicators of economy, which are GDP, remittance inflows, and inflation rate. As we can see in the graph, Bangladesh growth rate fell from 8.2% in 2019 to 7.8% in 2020, and it advanced to 8% in 2021, which is still less than 2019, and this advancement was because of global improvement in consumers' confidence towards market. Nepal's growth rate fell from 7.1% in 2019 to 5.3% in 2020. This huge change was because of clash down in the most major sectors, which was tourism and agriculture, but it rose to 6.4% in 2021. India being the largest among them had huge impact compared to others. On an average, South Asian countries had a substantial increase in their annual inflation from 3.3% in 2019 and real GDP at 6.6% in 2020. Further talking about the impact on the remittance inflows and inflation rate, the shutdowns have likely impacted private consumption in their growth. While remittances were robust in the first half of the year, they were likely to decline, reducing household consumption. Inflation in Bangladesh slowed following good crop harvest, and current account deficit narrowed as the trade deficit shrank and remittance expanded further. Consumer price inflation in India spiked about 2% to 6% in December 2019 and moved up from 4.6% in 2019 to 6% in Nepal. The dramatic spread of COVID-19 has affected trade, economy and businesses heading toward the severe recession. The business had shut down, hampering trading, and henceforth lesser industrial production, shortage of workers, etc., affecting the economy. Few industries affected are manufacturing industry. This industry plays a vital role in the economic growth of developing countries. Countries with fewer manufacturing opportunities were less affected than those with high level of manufacturing of light and heavy products like India. From the table, we can say that the percent of total GDP and sector GDP decline in negative. In COVID-19, pharmaceutical resources associated in this region ramped up to South Asian countries, which showed strong GDP growth, and however in 2019, it ended up being lower than expected. India being largest provider of generic drugs globally, Indian pharmaceutical sector supplies over 50% of global demand for various vaccines, and it grew to $100 billion. Bangladesh local pharmaceutical industries emerged as game changer, contributing 90% of overall medicine and currently exporting to 145 countries. In Nepal, the role of pharmaceutical industry is invaluable for economic revolution of country. Pharmaceutical market there is less regulated. Some of the most affected sectors in South Asia due to COVID are tourism, hotel and restaurant. which created around 50 million jobs in 2018, employed about 43 million people, which has been severely affected in COVID. The growth rate of this sector has decreased to 11.6% in Bangladesh, 6.7% in India, and 3.6% in Nepal. COVID-19 led to prolonged school closures to varying degrees. These affect the skills students acquire and eventually their productivity as future workforce. Learning losses range to 55%. The present value of these losses is estimated at $1.25 trillion. Now, talking about the booming sectors of the economy, the world witnessed one of its worst pandemics ever. The economy saw a gradual downfall in first wave. But still, the COVID and the lockdown has affected some sectors positively. Among them are e-retail sector. In the pandemic situation, people have come across online shopping platforms for groceries, which is no less than a boon for a e-retail sector because people couldn't move out of their house as per lockdown restrictions. The number of online shoppers in South Asia is growing annually by 5% and 9%. Healthcare sector. COVID-19 brought healthcare as a priority for everyone. The pandemic proved to be so disruptive that products like masks, sanitizer, and personal hygiene equipment immensely increased. Healthcare market is expected to reach $193.83 billion by 2020 and $372 billion by 2022, driven by rising income, better health awareness, lifestyle, diseases, and increasing access to insurance. Digital sector. During pandemic, people have begun to use digital media to work commitment, schooling, and entertainment. The use of online forums for business meeting has exploded in popularity. Online channels for digital content have become a big success with many movies released digitally, etc. because of limitations on gathering and crowd. Banking and finance sector. Unemployment and health problems has exacerbated the financial problem of the society. Regulated financial service providers and non-banking financial companies, NBFCs, play a critical role in such situations. In any situation, banks are not going to be immensely affected because people are going to invest, put their savings, etc., which will benefit them. These are some categories in which people were interested to invest during the pandemic, which are stock, real estate, gold, mutual funds, etc. Now, speaking about the impact on Uganda's economy, Uganda had a major impact too. Firms have experienced a significant drop in demand, revenue, and profits, and encountered difficulties in accessing customers, inputs, and suppliers. Employment and earnings also dropped significantly during lockdown, but not as much as firm revenues. As we can see from the graph, the fund requirement by public has increased in 2020 to $2,400 billion, and the share of budget has increased from 2.7% to 3.7%. Also, the ability of repaying outstanding loan is severely reduced. Majority in small and medium scale industries, whereas the large one has no impact. At the end of my presentation, I would like to say that every other problem has some way from it. In terms of government support, firms and employees highlighted interest rate subsidies, cash transfers, and social assistance grants as key policies to support recovery. India announced an economic stimulus package, 1.7 trillion rupees, for low-income families. So step by step, there will be an acceptance of new normal and the economic markets will improve. Learning from past experience from 1.5 years. Thank you so much. Stay safe and stay healthy.